This video shows how to follow up a significant interaction in a mixed ANOVA in R. As I already mentioned in my video for the mixed ANOVA itself, the main effects in the mixed ANOVA output are not to be interpreted when you have a significant interaction of your between subject and within subject factor. What needs to be calculated are estimated marginal means, meaning pairwise comparisons. Firstly, which of the groups differ at every point in time? Secondly, at which points in time the individual groups differ? In order to do the analysis, the emmeans-package needs to be installed and loaded, as well as the rstatix-package. I'll first examine group differences for every point in time. The calculation then starts with your data frame, the pipe operator, and the group by function. That includes the time variable, aka the within subject factor. Add another pipe operator and finally the emmeans_test function. Within it, you put the dependent variable first, then add tilde and conclude with your group variable, aka the between subject factor. Eventually, the p-adjust method is needed to control for alpha error inflation. Bonferroni is the most conservative one and multiplies the p-value with the number of pairwise comparisons. You can of course choose a different adjustment, albeit a justification is needed, at least with research field specific standards. In my example, I have only one comparison for the control group and experimental group at each point in time. The adjusted p-values can be seen in the p-adjust column. The last column holds significance indicators at the 5% alpha level, and is convenient to identify low enough p-values. I can observe two differences between the control and experimental group, once in T2 and once in T4. The second analysis is concerned with differences of groups over time. The code from above can be copied, and the within subject and between subject factors exchanged. In my example, each group has, because I took 5 measurements, 10 pairwise comparisons. Once again, the adjusted p-values and significance indicators at the 5% alpha level are the main focus. I got 4 low enough p-values, all of them in the experimental or intervention group, T0 and T2, T0 and T4, T1 and T4, and finally T3 and T4. The negative sign of the test statistic indicates that the value of the second point in time for each of those comparisons is higher, in my case, an increase in a score. What can now be concluded from these two outputs? First, the control and experimental group only show large enough differences twice, in T2 and T4. Depending on the scenarios, an intervention should show results right away, or as time goes on. In my case, it is the latter. Second, the control group shows no observable differences over time. Third, the experimental group shows higher values for the test variable as time goes on. For the last measurement in T4, differences to T0, T1 and T3 can each be observed. After investigating the interaction effect, I can continue reporting my results or calculate the effect size for the mixed ANOVA itself, which is optional.